you know, the nun's about a priest and a novitiate, a young novitiate who are tasked by the Vatican to investigate a series of sort of strange occurrences that are happening at a convent, a cloistered convent in the heart of Romania. The movie kicks off with the discovery of a nun hanging outside the entrance, and it's discovered by a local named Frenchie, who has the job of delivering supplies to the castle, you know, every couple of weeks. And he's always been uneasy dropping off these supplies, but of course seeing this really puts him on high alert, and he reaches out and to some local authorities, and word gets back to the Vatican, and that's where our leads, Father Burke and Sister Irene, come in. The story, I think, has a couple layers to it, and I also want to reflect that in the location as well. So, you know, in the first act, we're sort of on the surface, we're on the outside of the castle. In the second act, we cross over. Now we're inside the castle and on the couple of the ground floor and the upper levels. And then in the third act, we start to go deeper into the castle and underneath it, as we start to get into the real grit and grime of not just the story, but also the castle. So those are the things I was sort of thinking about when I sort of plotted out and structured the movie. He's so visual in how he thinks. You know, he sketches out his ideas. He does the storyboards on the fly. He looks at the scares and goes, okay, this is how I'm thinking of sort of doing the reveal. And also, you know, it wasn't just about the scares for him. He really sort of fell in love with the world. He fell in love with the characters. He fell in love with their backstories and where they could go in the future. Like, he really just seemed to really embrace everything about the movie and just, you know, kind of really ended up making it his own. I'm sure James has his ideas about where he'd like to end up. You know, I don't think that, you know, I think, and in terms of, like, I think of it in terms of chapters, right? I don't think he has a, you know, happily ever after the end to the story, but I do think he sees it in terms of chapters. Like, here's this movie or this series of movies is going to tell this chapter in the lives of Ed and Lorraine or Annabelle or whoever, and then that chapter is going to come to an end, but it leads into this next chapter.